Okay, it's a little sandblasting kit I got. This is $20, you know. It's a real simple one by Cambell Hausfield, and you know, I heard it's not bad as long as you shorten the hose. So I made the hose like less than half the length. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try it out with this little compressor, which I know is too small, because I'm going to get a bigger compressor, and this sandblaster thing is rated for 9 CFM, you know, CFM at 9 CFM at 90 pounds. This is 2.6. Now, I'm either going to get in a 220 volt, and I'm kind of talking myself out of that already. It's 11 CFM at 90 pounds. It'll easily handle this sandblaster, or I might get a 5.6 CFM. The 220 volt's got a 60 gallon tank, and the 120 volt has a 30 gallon tank, but it's got wheels on it and stuff because I'm a home user. But I want to see how it works with this little puppy. This thing is definitely not made for this, so I'm going to try it out on this little piece of steel. I was cutting it for the Jeep, and you got to clean off the crap on it. I was going to, you know, clean it off with soap and then grind it, but I said, let me give this a test. So, you know, I got a shield here. My shield was cheap, $13. It's a ratcheted type. It's a good one. Got some more hose, and give it a shot. Now, suffice to say, now for me, I just decided I'm not going to get the 220 volt air compressor because I'm a home user, and I'm going to get a 120 volt. They're, both of those models are cast iron, oil type, you know, they're good quality, 3-year warranty, and I'm a home user. I'm going to get the 120 volt, but considering that this little guy right here, this 2.6, and the one I'm going to replace it with is a 5.6. This little guy here with the 8-gallon tank, which is about, you know, about 28% of what you're supposed to be using, right, for CFM. You're supposed to use 9 CFM per 90 pounds. And considering the one I'm going to get a 120 volt, not the 240. I'm just testing this out right now. The 120 volt's got a 30-gallon tank, it's got 5.6 CFM, and it's got 155 max PSI. And it's a Kohler or a Cambell housing. This thing, I had this thing a long time. These aren't supposed to last that long, and it's been lasting. But look, you know, nice clean surface, right? This crap is actually hard to grind off because I tried grinding it off. It's some kind of stuff that's on there. They apply it when, what the hell you call it, like when you get a new piece of steel. So I'm going to, you know, blast this whole thing off. And, you know, it's pretty good. So, and I figure for me, even if I want to do a whole damn car, this little $20 gun, that's regular beach play sand. That's all that crap is. You shorten up the hose so it don't clog up much, right? That's the whole trick to this damn thing. It's got to have a shorter hose. Like, I got a hell of a lot more hose with it, and I just cut it off, you know? I made the hose about a third as long, so maybe that's a 4-foot hose max. That's the difference. That's why it works. So, good to go. And just decided I'm not going to get, I didn't want to get the 240 volt compressor because I was kind of leaning towards that for sandblasting, but now I realize if this little guy can almost do the job in pieces, something more than twice as powerful as this is going to do, like, I could do a whole fender with this thing, no problem. It's like I'm just a home user. So just want to point out, this is a $20 sandblaster kit, $20. It's by Cambell Hausfield. It's not bad. This shield is a pretty good shield. It's you can use it for grinding and stuff. I usually use safety goggles. But the shield is $12. $12. It's ratcheted and all this type of stuff. They got more hose, so. But I just wanted to point this out for some DIY guys that are just basically, you know, want to do some sandblasting and some parts. Because here's the deal. If you want to use, what do you call it? Let me get it over here, too. If you want to use this stuff, chassis saver, right? The whole idea is the preparation. And the trick to the preparation is to not have a smooth surface. You got to have a grip. And if you sandblast, you're going to have a good grip on anything. As a matter of fact, I'm going to tell you this is another trick just to throw this in the video, because I know some shit from body work and stuff. Say, for instance, not that I'm going to do it with these bumpers. Say you wanted to paint some chrome bumpers with paint, right? Regular paint. And you want it to stick. You can do it as long as the chrome doesn't flake off. But the whole deal is not, you don't sand it. You don't grind it. You don't sand it. You bead blast it or you lightly sand blast it. Then you use a good type of primer, you know. I mean, this is even before the days of primers, you know, the good primers they got, the epoxy primers. I'm talking about from like 30 years ago. If you bead blasted this or sand blasted chrome, you can paint it. If you grind it or sand it with the DA, it doesn't stick. So I want to throw that little tip in the video here because, I don't know. I know a lot of little stupid things about this kind of crap, to tell you the truth. So, you know, that's another reason to have the sandblaster. So, what I could do now is, you know, if I wanted to take this part off, sandblast this little part, and paint it and prime it versus getting it chromed, you know, you can get a custom look. This can be black, right? This can be black. And how much money would that save you? Plus, it would stick good, too, because it's prepared right. That's the whole key. But again, looks like you don't need too much power. You don't need, for a home user, you don't really need the 9 CFM per 90 pounds. This was 2.6. And if I was doing a small part, I could even get by with this. I'm going to get that 5.6 30-gallon tank, which is 2.5 times, 30-gallon tank is actually 3.5 times the size of this, and it's 155 max PSI. So I'd probably be able to sandblast the whole fender with this, with a smaller compressor than what this is, this $20 sandblaster is rated for. So I want to pass on this tip because I think this can save the home user, the DIY type of guy, the real DIY type of guy, some bucks. And you're not throwing a lot of money into all kinds of equipment you don't need, you know, because they're always trying to sell you bullshit, right? You can get by with a lot less if you're not doing this shit every day for a living. That's the point.